Hello, welcome to Money Mantan TV. Today we are going to discuss about risk of investments with Chartered Accountant K. Hanumanlo. Hello, Namaskar. Welcome sir.
Namaskar.
So sir, can you tell me about the investment? What is investment?
See, investment means you expect something return.
Yeah.
With gain or without gain or with some loss. But there is expectation of return. That is called investment. So, expenditure is different. Once you have spent, you will not get anything.
And people are more like confused about investment and expenditure.
All expenditure are not investments. All investments are not expenditure.
Exactly.
So what should gain? Investment is how what you are getting in return. Mm-hmm. Maybe satisfaction. Maybe credibility in the society. Maybe return back with addition. Everything is called investment. Mm-hmm. So this is when you get something in return is called investment. There is the expenditure is not like that. This is only to spend what you want to show. Nothing without any expectation, nothing is expected from expenditure. So this is the difference between expenditure and investment.
So sir, what is the purpose of investment, business and income, satisfaction, all these things?
See, there is there are so many ways of thinking of the people. See, a person feels that he is happy if he is protected his future. He is happy if he is protected his children's future. He is happy with if he has got regular income. And he is happy with no risk. And he is happy with ready to take risk. So it depends upon his planning. So everything is depends upon this investment's nature. What we will feel is, suppose if you are earning now, so what should we do after 60 years? We may not be able to earn. So we should protect our future after 60 years age. How we protect is, we take insurance policies, we take bank deposits, or we'll purchase some property, and we'll get a rental income. And this is the source of income altogether. See, this is the purpose, what purpose you want to invest is first, that is called. And next is period. When do you require that money back?
Yeah.
Maybe 1 year, after 1 year, or 2 years, or 10 years, 20 years, 50 years. Mm-hmm. Or not at all required, you may require after some time, after next generation. So this is period of investment, nature of investment, risk of investment. All these things are depends upon the, it will influence the nature of investment also. So this is the mentality what will feel that suppose a student is there, if he feels that his education is protected from to meet his fees expenditure, education expenditure, or his study material, books are like that. So that is his investment for education. Suppose you purchase a house, that is the investment for a house, for your residential purpose. If you purchase a commercial property, you are protecting your income, continuous income for this one. And if you are investing in bank deposits, so you don't want to take any risk, you want fixed income. So that is insurance. If anything happens in the in between, to protect the future success, and also to get something after the prescribed age, that is insurance coverage. So all these things are different types of investments, and everybody plans all types of investment also, not only one time. Every type of plans to invest. Suppose we invest in gold also, sometimes it may, if you want to, need of money, you can sell that gold and convert into cash and you can use for it, emergency. And health insurance also investment, to meet the unexpected, unforeseen events also, anything happens. And unexpected fever or anything, chronic disease also will be protected from insurance coverage, health insurance. All these are investments.
Mm-hmm.
So this is, all this will protect the person from risks,
mm-hmm.
unexpected events, unexpected SARS, anything. To protect him, that is called investment.
Okay. Sir, who are the beneficiaries of investment? Self or else successor, society, commercial?
I told you earlier, one invests for himself, mm-hmm. is self himself. If he invests for family, the entire family will be benefited. Where he invests for next generation,
mm-hmm.
next generation will be benefited. If he invests for society, means if he gives a constructive school and donates to the government, donate to the society. That is, his satisfaction is to invest for the society. And some people donates free food. means he is investing for society for better upliftment. If he invests for student fees, education fees or books or something, this means it depends upon, it is not investment, you can say it is charity. But his satisfaction, what he is getting is investment. Mm-hmm. So that is also called investment depends upon the purpose for what you are going to use. So that is the way I told you earlier, in so many, so many ways also, so many purposes also you can get investment. So it depends upon the bifurcation of his sources, his savings into different source of investments called investments.
So now these days, if you have seen that many people wants money, everyone wants money, right? But nobody wants to invest, nobody wants to take risk. So how to motivate to invest like in any business or anything?
See, investment is generally feel that investment, if you have lakhs and crores only, you are an investor. So it is not like that. Investment means even if you save 100 rupees and you keep in a bank, that the bank will give loan to somebody else to earn money. So this is investment, the deposit for your, it is investment. For them, it is a source for doing, carrying their activity. The same way, any investment, it depends upon risk, how much risk you want to take. Suppose if you are depositing, making a deposit in the post office or bank, there is no risk at all. There is low risk. If you are investing in property and it gold, if you want to liquidate after some time, if it is possible, to, you may get same rate or say excess rate or reduce rate also. There is a medium risk and there is a low risk. If it is a medium risk, if you have constructed some property or if you have given invested in business of activity, somebody managed by somebody else or partnership firms or company share or company shares, so it is medium risk. It may come back with addition value or it may come back with reduced value. Mm-hmm. So it is not, I'm not talking about speculation. Mm-hmm. So I'm talking about actual delivery. Mm-hmm. Actual delivery of shares is called, that is investment in share, that is a medium risk. And high risk is you are carrying on speculation activity, purchasing lottery ticket is also high risk. You may lose entire every money, everything. Or you may get more also.
Yeah.
Even share speculation, share market also, commodities also. Mm-hmm. And all these are patent rights. There is no value at all, but you are creating value and you are purchasing the risk. So that is high risk.
Mm-hmm.
So all one should distribute all his savings in different sectors. Low risk, no risk, low risk, high risk, medium risk and high risk.
Mm-hmm.
And if he is capable to lose money also, he can go for high risk. If he is not ready to take, not willing to lose anything, he has to go for no risk.
Mm-hmm.
In between, he can shift the balance.
Mm-hmm.
So this is the way he has to spread his investments in such a way that everything is covered so that he should be in a position to bear the loss without expecting gain at every investment.
So what are the expectation of investment? Like
I told you, investment means generally the people who are investing in the bank department, they expect only interest. They cannot get more than that. If a person invests in property, he will get only rent. He will not get anything more. He wants to do the business. He may get more also. So he may lose also.
Mm-hmm.
The same thing, the same money, the same but the utilization is different.
Yeah.
Suppose a person opens a restaurant and invests money. He purchases a commercial place and he opens a restaurant. He may lose the money. He may gain the money also. But if he gives it on rent,
mm-hmm.
the same building, he will get assured money.
Yeah.
And see, this is the difference. When ready, risk carries reward. If a person is ready to take risk, he may get reward also. If he is ready to take risk, they may loss also. So dare to invest, dare to earn, and dare to lose also. That should be the concept of risk of investment.
Okay, sir. So how risk affects investment?
I told you earlier, risk is always carries reward.
Mm-hmm.
Or total loss also.
Yeah.
So when you want to take, suppose you are having 10 lakhs rupees. You cannot take entire 10 lakhs because some savings for so many years. You cannot take entire 10 lakhs into risky business. Out of that, you can deposit 5 lakhs in bank deposits so that there is no risk. Another 2 lakhs, you may go for gold purchase or property purchase. There is low risk. If you go for businessman shares or investment for another 2 lakhs, that is high risk, medium risk. If you go for speculation with another 1 lakh, so that you may lose this 1 lakh only, not 10 lakhs. So this is the way, how much you are ready to lose is ready to decides how much you want to invest in risky and no risky investments.
How long to invest, sir?
Yes, it depends upon the period. Suppose you need after 5 years the money back, so you want to make deposit in 5 years, after 5 years returnable. If you don't need at all any time, you may invest for longer period also. How you need, when you need, and how you need that. And you are right to take risk or not, it depends upon that. That decides the investment, the character of investment.
Thank you, sir.
Welcome.